Hello and welcome to this latest edition of Farhang Foundation with me, Chef Mojdeh. I'm your host, Chef Mojdeh, and I'm delighted to have you join us our dinner party here in Los Angeles. In each episode of this series, we invite 6 influential Iranians from different backgrounds to join us for a tasting experience of some of Iran's most iconic regional dishes. Join me as we sit down with tonight's special guests and discuss their backgrounds, influences, and how their Iranian heritage has influenced their successful careers. Today's amazing guests include journalist, television and radio host, RUDI BAKHTIAR, one of the pioneers of Iranian rap and a successful entrepreneur and producer, the one and only Erfan, comedian, sketch artist, and co-founder of Chalad's design, Sahar Golshani, renowned actress, Sara Seyed, composer, vocalist, and sitar virtuoso, Farhang Shafinuri. And last but not least, actress and comedian, Melissa Shoshahi. I have to also give a special shout out to Farhang Foundation Generation Council for helping make this series a reality. Today, I'm gonna take you to Mazandaran, which is located in north of Iran. I'm gonna show you how to make fesenjoon. Let's go to Mazandaran. These are the ingredients for fesenjoon. Chicken fillet, onion finely chopped, pomegranate molasses, rose water, saffron, turmeric, pepper, salt, sugar, and ground walnut. First, we add oil and the onion and saute onion in oil till golden. We add salt, pepper, and turmeric. We add the chicken. To get the golden brown. In another pan, we add ground walnut. Remember, don't add any oil because walnut has a lot of oil. And stir it for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you add hot water. Into a pot. When the chicken half cooked, you take out the chicken and put it on the side. We add the walnut to our saute onion and let it cook for 20 minutes. We add the pomegranate molasses and sugar. Stir it and put the lid on and let it cook for another 20 minutes. Wow, the aroma from walnut and pomegranate is fantastic. Now is the time to put the chicken back. Now we add the rose water and saffron. And let it cook for another 10 minutes and the fesanjun is ready.
نسیمی که از بنه آن کاکلایه مرا خوش از بوی سنبنایه
Hello ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
I'm very happy that you guys are here.
We're happy to be here.
Thank you.
We have a three-course dinner tonight, and this is the first course. The first course is called Zoymaj. It's originally actually called Doymaj, very old traditional appetizer from Qazvin. Qazvin. And I changed the recipe, sauteed the Zeresh barberry and add it to the doymaj and I call doymaj. Dried lavash, sauté onion and herbs.
Say no more.
And feta cheese. Yeah, it's very interesting. Actually,
my Turkish side, we would have it.
Good. Yeah. And with this actually course, I paired a very nice rosé from Ashes and Diamonds, owned by Kashi Khalidi.
Beautiful. Ooh.
And I think it's fantastic with this course.
I bet you're right.
Thank you, chef.
Oh, yeah. Lavash and feta.
Yes.
This,
of course. Bacho, you take it like this and put the whole thing in your mouth.
Soymaj.
Cheers.
Our first soymaj collection.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Okay, that is yummy.
Uh, That's so good.
What? That's absolutely delicious.
Week has been completed.
Wow.
Go in my Mondays from now on.
That is so good.
Well, mm-hmm. I think we need to top it off with a little bit of this paired application.
Are you guys having fun?
Absolutely.
Yes. 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 Too much fun.
Very nice. This is the second course. Khoreshte Pesanjum.
My favorite.
There are two reasons that I chose to actually serve Pesanjum for you. The first reason, because it's Rudy's favorite stew.
Nice.
And the second reason, because of Tirgan Festival. Tirgan is an old Iranian tradition which happens in summer and celebrates rain. Legend says the boundary between Iran and Turan was set by Arash Kamangir. He launched his arrow, which was traveling for days and days and days and days, and finally landing by a walnut. I serve your Pesanjum with the garnish of pomegranate seed and gold. Are you guys enjoying your time?
Absolutely.
How was the Pesanjum?
Royal.
Lovely. Royal.
It was so June.
The third course is Mashkufi, a dessert from Mazandaran. I promise you, when you have the first bite in your mouth, it's going to take you to your childhood.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Enjoy. And with that, I make you pomegranate and cornelian cherry liqueur. Wow. What's cornelian cherry?
Maybe Roman Empire.
No,
maybe
it's a
zogalakhte.
Oh, is that what it's called?
Cranberry.
Can I have all of it?
Sure. I'll
take some home.
Ram.
But cornelian is also a type of stone, if I'm not mistaken.
Is it that color?
Yeah. Okay, I think cornelian is like what we know
So now we're using the shot glass.
Okay.
I think this is the very nice match.
Oh, beautiful. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Just like the group tonight.
It feels like someone's blood, though.
I want to tell you something.
Two things, please.
This is a gift from Farhang Foundation and I for you guys.
Oh,
and written by Mojdeh.
I know him.
He's very talented. And there's attached of Fala Hafez.
Shall we
read it?
Sure.
Are they all the same or different ones?
I have no idea.
Yeah, someone has to translate once I read it because I won't understand.
Oh, absolutely. Because I know half of it.
Yes, let's do it.
Come on.
Baba,
It's Hafiz's first poem.
Del sara parde mohabbat oust dide aine dar at la'at oust تو و توبی و ما و قامت یار فکر هر کس به قدر به قدر همت اوست. عده شما را سرزنش میکنن و تعدادی نیز به شما حسادت میورزن و بعضی هم در انصراف شما میکوشند، اما کسانی در این بین شما را تشویق کرده و ترغیب میکنند. بدان که این نیت با کمی صبر و حوصله و تلاش حتما تحقق پیدا میکند. از اینکه دست شما نمک ندارد شکی نمیباشد، ولی چرخ زندگی شما همیشه به خوبی در حرکت است.
صحرا چه
قول قشنگی. رازی که بر غیر نگفتیم و نگوییم، با دوست بگوییم که اون محرم راز است. بردوختم دیده تو باز از همه عالم، تا دیده من بر رخ زیبای تو باز است. حتما اوضاع بر وفق مراد است و جای هیچ گونه نگرانی و استرا وجود ندارد و این دل مشغولی جناب عالی از وسواس و بی‌حوصلگی ناشی می شود. This is Rudy's.
Okay, ma'am.
شما شخصی هستی که برای کارهای بزرگ عزم و اراده داره. قوی داری. به خاطر همین اطرافیان خیلی به شما نزدیک می شود. تا از این خصلت شما حسن و استفاده ببرن. کمک به زیر دستان رو دوست داری و این کار روزی فراوان رو برای شما سبب شده. با همه این حال توکل به خدا رو از یاد مبرم.
That's the part that...
And you're strong, you got it, but you know. Don't forget to.
Universe.
Lean on God.
Universe. God is the universe.
دوش در حلقه ما قصه گیسوی تو بود، تا دل شب سخن از سلسله موی تو بود. دل که از ناوک مژگان تو در خون میگشت، باز مشتاق کمان خانه ابروی تو بود. It's about a story to the heart of the night. دوش در حلقه ما قصه گیسوی تو بود. So the heart of night, we were sitting around talking about your luscious, beautiful hair. Like, Sahar's beautiful hair.
Is it you? Walking away? Is it love? Coming our way?
Okay, tell me about the dessert.
Fantastic.
Heavenly. It kind of reminds me of Ferini or that something, not Yachtar Behesht.
Yachtar Behesht.
Not Yachtar, no.
What kind of Yachtar Behesht?
No, there is something with the term Behesht in it, and it's like white.
Ferini is very close to Ferini.
It's like Ferini. Yeah. Everybody's saying like the randomly.
Okay, guys, I'm very happy you guys are here. And I want to ask you a question. That how did Iranian culture influenced you to be very successful?
Mm. Wow.
Just tell me a little bit about yourself.
I think what's wonderful about being Iranian, I would love to know what everyone thinks, but just for me personally, just by nature of being an Iranian girl, raised and educated in Iran, at least for the first part of my life, was that you, from the get-go, see a lot of colors and beauty and love and extraordinary, you know, bond amongst family and culture and food, which is, by the way, that's why I keep telling you, I'm like, you have love in your plates.
Oh, thank you.
And that's why this is nostalgic, is that you also instantly get acquainted with a lot of things that I think very early on people from the rest of the world, I'm not suggesting anyone doesn't, but you see discrimination, you see human rights abuse, you see all of that right off the bat. And then you go, well, then I want to engage in the kind of storytelling that allows me to get in there, engage politically, socially, heart and soul, to want to change everything. And I think that's what's apparent in every young artist, Iranian artist that I see. Like, it's so purposeful.
Mm-hmm.
It's so about that. It's not just about fame and fortune. It's the words, it's like the storytelling, always, be it being a journalist, being a musician, and that's like, what we always take with us, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Beautiful. Yeah.
There were a lot of, because they say American history is 400 or 500 years old, so it's like, for us it's thousands of years old, so there's just so many people that we looked up to, we read about, that somehow, even if they had nothing to do with you, you kind of feel like, well, that could be me, that can be me. So compare yourself to the greats in whatever you do. So like me, myself, in writing, we have so many amazing poets that I'm like, what do I need to do to get to that level? You know what I mean? So I think that, and also part of it is because we're proud people. So when I come to this country, when I came to America, and I see my dad and everybody else and so many successful people in different levels. Mm-hmm. Some people financially, some people with education, you know, it's different. I wanted to set an example for the next generation and, you know, kind of be able to walk in different steps and, you know, be great at what I do.
Okay. I think the part of our culture that really helped me become successful is that nurturing part. We have a very nurturing culture. We have a beautiful culture that always wants to, you know, feed everyone. And I mean, look at our nose. And thanks to Farhang Foundation, we're actually bringing our noses here and spreading one of the most beautiful celebrations there can be, like the first day of spring. Mm-hmm. And look at our noses. It's meant to celebrate togetherness and feed each other. And it's like all about getting together. And I think, you know, that's the part that always helped me coming as an Iranian, coming into the American society. Even though I was born here, I grew up in Iran. And just, you know, that nurturing part really, I think, endeared me to people. Mm-hmm. And it really helped me climb that work ladder.
I have to say, for me, my Iranian culture influenced my comedy 100%, yeah. Especially when I started. Because when you start at stand-up, I was like, well, let me talk about what I know. And what I knew was how I grew up, my mom, my dad. They influenced me the most, and right. To me, the heart of it all, they are the funniest people I know. Our culture, there was so much I could pick from, and obviously I've branched off from that. You know, I've been doing stand-up for 11 years, but when I started, initially I was like, oh, let me talk about what I know, and that was my culture. So it's influenced me tremendously, and it's dear to my heart, and I love everything about it.
Yeah. That's why I can't have a long conversation with my mom, because she's like, Ask me a question. I'm like, are you going to listen to what I'm going to tell you? She's like, yeah. Within 10 seconds, do you want to eat Talibi? I keep asking, like, that's how she wants to give me love, because she doesn't see me often.
Yeah. You know, our culture has this element where we can all partake in it, and especially since, you know, there is this real, like, strife or this lack thereof of an actual physical homeland for so many people. Yeah. So us as diasporic Iranians, mm-hmm. and to such a large degree, our identity really informs who we are in almost every element, from cuisine to comedy to music to poetry. Definitely. To, you know, the way we actually bring about community and cultivate community. Yeah. So for me, what I find to have been most influential is obviously, you know, Persian poetry. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I think Persian poetry has really helped inform my music, my musicality. It's informed me on every level as a person. And I actually think there is a humility to that, because everybody has access to it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's not just the 5-6 people, mm-hmm. here. The entire country is aware of Hafiz. They can recite these poems from age 5 all the way up to 50. So I think that accessibility of our culture really brings about, I think, without our culture, we fall apart. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so absolutely. Essentially, I think that's the unifying ingredient in all of this food that we've had, this, mm-hmm. lovely food. Thank you, Mojdeh.
Thank John. You.
Has
Thank
been you pouring in this love from our ancient ancestors, and I'm very grateful for it.
That line you said about without our culture, we fall apart, I feel that resonates with me a lot. Right. I've never been to Iran, as you guys know, so for me, your question was, what part of the culture inspires you to be successful? I think just the culture as a whole. I feel like a lot of kids who grow up here, they stray away from their culture because they want to fit into Western society, and that's again what really catapults me to do everything that I do, because I want to make sure that we're keeping that culture alive, because a lot of kids who grow up here stray away from that and they don't have that. So I want to be that example where it's like, we can stick with our culture and we can be proud of it.
Yeah. How old were you when you left Iran?
I've never been to Iran.
Oh my God! Yeah.
Isn't that incredible? Yeah.
My culture is what makes me cool. Mm-hmm. That's what makes me different from
Samantha and Sarah and Tiffany and, you know, those people. Yeah. So
and we have an origin story. Yeah. To go back.
People
in this country, a lot of migrants from different places in Europe, all over the place, right? But they don't have origin story. A lot of them, they don't know where they came from.
And, yeah. I mean, and it's different from patriotism. I think we're not crazy patriotic. We just love it. I mean, my father thinks it was the Big Bang and then the Persian Empire. It was like there was no time in between. It was like we were the first. And everyone who sits down, they're like, he's like refrigerator.
When you can't claim your territory in the world, like you see a lot of countries able to do, you have to claim your culture.
Mm-hmm.
When you don't have borders that you can really sustain in a way where you can be like, this is, I mean, the whole premise of what means to be Iranian or Persian really comes down to what we're passing on from our beautiful parents to our kids to our you know, grandchildren. And I feel that this is something that's making the diaspora so strong, and I really hope that, you know, we can bridge together the Iranians within Iran with this diaspora element. I think
can
that would
I
be.
Can I add something to that? Because it's interesting. I also think that that's why it's created such fighters in like the younger generation, because we see what our culture is, which is welcoming, understanding, respectful, like constantly bringing in. It's colorful.
And
it's
open.
Like it doesn't understand discrimination. We were like, weren't we the first cylinder of human rights? Should I throw in that in there?
Yes.
Big it up, Cyrus. But what I'm trying to say is we grew up with that.
Uh-huh.
And then we see something being forced on us after the revolution, thinking, well, it doesn't pan out for me as a young woman of, as a man, as what have you. And that's why in our art, there's so much more. The underneath, the like undercurrent is just so much fuller than any other. And that's what I take with me. It's not that I'm Iranian from Iran and Iran has 5,000 years of history. That's great, because I don't want to hang on to that, but I want to hang on to things that color what I am and what we're all about and what we're fighting for, which was the purpose I was talking about.
Right.
Okay, I want to thank our amazing guests. Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to be here tonight. I'm truly honored to have you with us tonight. Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Also, I want to say thank you to our hosts, Sabrina and Kami Yunesi, for allowing us to film tonight's episode in their beautiful house. And of course, I have to say thank you to Farhang Foundation, seriously, for supporting this program and everything they do in promoting Iranian culture. I bid you farewell and looking forward to seeing you again.
Cheers, everybody.
Thank you.
Cheers. من از چشات میترسم از اون نگات میترسم من رو قربونت کنه ایشالله اسیرت رو چشمونت کنه ایشالله
کاش تو هم حال منو داشتی کاش تو هم حال منو داشتی
آره
کجا میری بروری ترسم بری و بمونی خدا منو قربونش کنه
ایشالله
از سینه دو چشمونش کنه
ایشالله